our presentation, we're going to call the mobile learning system we have specifically created for learning German language. And we care a lot about this in the process. First of all, we've used for 5 years a very simple game in our classroom. It was a paper-based game where each student has one agenda. And each student has to fill the agenda with different activities. They are collaborative activities. You have to go to the cinema with other mates in the classroom. You have to go to the zoo with other one. So you have to jointly arrange the activities with other classmates. They did so by writing small pieces of papers. Would you like to go to the cinema on Friday? And then you get the answer. A few minutes later, I could go, but only in the afternoon, because in the evening I already have something arranged. And it was very funny. They really have good time in the classroom. In the beginning you have an empty agenda, but at the end you have a full agenda full of things to do, and a lot of papers here, a stack of papers. It was great. It was just listening to the teacher talking all in German, and so it was fun. But we thought that the ICT technologies could provide something additional. We identified 5 aspects they could improve. First was the students could be anonymized. That's something very interesting, because sometimes students, they really realize that they would say, mañana. They use the native language, not the only language we want to use. We want them to express, even if it's difficult, they have to try. So when you are anonymized, you don't know who you are talking with, you have to see some random names. Other thing was that the misunderstanding are automatically detected. If I arrange go to the zoo with someone on Friday, and I note down that I will go on Saturday, and the other mate notice down that we will go on Thursday, in a paper, nobody will realize. You think that you have arranged something, but not. So we have used it, I will later show you, different lights to show it. They have a bridge for it. Also, it's good for large groups. When you have 10 students in the classroom, it's a rate. When you have 100, it's a problem. And you can do a lot of papers, and you write some people, and then you need 10 or 20 minutes to get the answer back, and then you say, I have the Friday evening available, and then when you get the answer, you don't have. So it's quick and good for that. Also, it's great monitoring the process. We have all the chats loaded down, we have access to all the agendas, and we can see all the process, how it was developed. And it could be also used out of the classroom, so we haven't used it already yet. So we created a client server architecture. We have a server with a specific teacher for a specific application for the teacher. When the teacher sets up the groups of the students, the activities I will show you. Then the students interact with each other using the server. Everything is anonymous, so they don't know who are they talking with. And then finally we get some reports. Provides very in-depth information. It's obviously automatically created. This is the teacher app. Basically, you have to define the task you want to do. You want to go to work. Locations where you have to pay activities, going to the cinema, going to the zoo, going to the theater. If you want to work sports, you have to arrange going to do with surfing or going to play golf, whatever. You also have to create the activities showing how many students you want. Usually we use activities by 2 partners, but you can create activities by 3. It's even more complex because you have to arrange going to the cinema with 3 other students. And then you can create one group for all the classroom. You can divide the classroom into different groups according to the level, according to the skills, according to whatever you want. And this is the student app. This is the first screen you see. You have an empty schedule. These are the... This is German, I don't know German language. This is the days of the week, and these are the morning, evening, afternoon. So. So you are empty, you have a lot of activities to do, going to the cinema, the disco, going to study, going to the football stadium, and you say chat, and then you have a lot of names that are not real at all. You click on a name, then you start writing, I'd like to go someplace. Do you like? Yes, I will go. And when you have arranged the place to go and the details, because also it was very interesting that the teacher, the German teacher that supported, who supported the development of the application, insisted that, that she wanted different things to do. You go to the stadium, okay, but in which location? What match would you see? Because those are different skills that are required from our students. So when you have arranged the activity and all the details, you fill in the details and you note it down in your agenda. If you have arranged something that was arranged by the other side, you have green light. If you have arranged something that does not agree, what the other people have written, you have the red light. So you see red light, you wait a few seconds in case the other thing is really typing. But if it's keep record, you have to go and say, hey, I think we talked about going to the football stadium Friday evening. Is it alright or not? No, I understood it was in the morning, and you can keep talking and learning, which is an important thing. We played the game 3 times. It was 1 hour length, each game. We had an experimental group with the app and a control group with the paper version of the game. We collected data from 1 pretest and 4 post-tests, and also a technology acceptance model questionnaire. Well, the final result, because we haven't had time to, we have the problem with this is that you have a lot of data. Analyzing all those data takes time, really. It takes a lot of time. We analyzed how many messages students wrote compared with the average, and so the proportion of the conversation that students used. But probably this graph is the most important, most interesting data insight we have made at the moment. You see the circles. Each circle is a student. The biggest the circle is the more activities he or she has arranged properly. And the width of the lines, the lines are very thick, it means that they have spoken, they have written a lot of words. And it's not easy to see, but some lines are a bit dotted. They are thick or not thick, but they are dotted. If they are dotted, it means that they have used a lot of words that are not German. They can be Spanish, they can be German bad written words, or whatever. And using this graph, we can compare the different groups, how they behaved, and the dynamics. And we had definitely something, we had to, of course it's visual, so it's not definitely with figures, but we had detected something. It seems that also, we don't tell the students that playing the game with a paper or playing the game with the app was the same game and they would be assessed according to the same criteria. It seems that when they used the paper version of the game, they did take time to write carefully. They used the correct declinations in German, or well, what they expected to be the correct declination. They took time to think the word has an H in the middle or not. Okay, I think it's like that, I will write it correctly. And they took care to write good German. But this is the student with the app where you're seeing like WhatsApp they have in the groups and so. So they started writing words with mistakes and they didn't take time to correct the mistakes. They just say, okay, yes, no, Friday. And I say, okay, it's like an exam, so take care and write carefully because it's not filling the gaps with different activities. It's speaking German with other people. So you see that we insisted in that aspect. They really behave differently using the tablets of the math paper or using the paper for the same game. Conclusions were the brain, the game already worked well in the paper version, but it was somehow enhanced using the digital version. the most interesting thing is that we can monitor the learning process. So now we have, well, we have there from the control group, we have a lot of papers to analyze, and it's a problem. We have some students helping us to translate all those into digital format to be analyzed, but it's a problem really. But with the digital data, it's quickly. If you want to make a graph, you make it quickly, so it's great. Also, using the anonymity, we think that the amount of information, the amount of students using their native language was smaller because they knew that they were going to be somehow supervised. Mm-hmm. So they most of them only use the German language. The massive misunderstandings are checked. Mm-hmm. Something I, in the previous years, I felt a lot of students spoke with others that they didn't arrange. So we made a short group and small groups or large groups with no different. Mm-hmm. In future, where we would like to make a deeper analysis of information, both quantitative, the number of messages, the time taking to write each message, and so, and qualitative, if the analysis works or not. Mm-hmm. Behavioral patterns, if they behave according to different patterns. And also assessing specific competencies. Probably there are some students who are good at some competencies, and all that. Okay? And also standing again. Mm-hmm. So, thank you for attention.